places that are worth to know as Bogotá, right? But there is also one thing that we don't usually like to talk about, and that is violence. Violence is not in our nature. I think that we learn it from other countries. Actually, we were asked to participate in world wars that were not ours. So, please be sure of bringing to our country peace, knowledge, love, because we already receive too much hate, too much violence. The oral history is represented in one name, Campo Elias Delgado. Pozzeto's murder, who killed 20 people in one of the most famous restaurants in Bogotá at that time. But if we want to understand what were the reasons that made this man lost his mind, we have to know first how his life was. So first of all, his dad committed suicide when he was just 14 years old. He was devastated. And also, that was the time when he started loving and hating his mom, because rumors were spread around the town that his mom was cheating on her husband, which made this man took this terrible decision. But in 1970, he was drafted to the Vietnam War, and he served as a volunteer in the second time. But I think that these events released his bloody thirsting, because when he came back to Bogotá, he felt all the time how much he missed the shoots, the enemy's blood, all the bodies that he left behind. Also, he couldn't put up with living a regular life, with a normal job, with having kids, with having a dog, with driving to work. Also, I think that he wouldn't have assist to this kind of events, of storytelling shows. He felt repulsion for homeless people. The thing that bothered him the most was their self-pity. But you know, I think that he felt this hate because he could identify himself with all those people, both lonely, both forgotten by the society. He considered himself as a lonely person. He couldn't build any lasting relationship. In fact, he felt this sex desire, but he couldn't have any sex relationship because he thought that a woman body was disgusting. Can you imagine that? Also, he was a cleaning obsessive person. Moreover, he felt annoyed by many daily things, like horns, like planes, sounds, like people in general. I really can't imagine being in his skin. That life must be really, really sad. Well, now that you know a little bit about Campo Elias' story, now let's talk about one of the most terrifying days in our country. The murders started a cold morning near to Christmas on December 4th of 1986. It started in the apartment of a Campo Elias student. He stabbed to death his 15 years pupil with his mother, without feeling any mercy, any compassion. Then he returned to his apartment that he shared with his mother. He packed his briefcase and with a pistol and ammunition. He got close to his mother and killed her just with one step in the back of the neck. Then he wrote her on newspapers and set them on fire. He left his apartment, and when he was walking through the main hallway, he killed five more people. Then he left the building to the Italian restaurant. There, he was carrying a knife, five boxes of ammunition, and a 32 caliber revolver hidden in his briefcase. That night, certain people that just wanted to enjoy a quiet dinner didn't know how it's gonna be their tragic destiny. Campo arrived to a restaurant at 7:30 p.m. He ordered his favorite meal. It was pasta, la bolognese, red wine, and eight vodka tonics. When he finished the meal, he started shooting all people around. He shot to death 20 people until the police officers arrived to the restaurant. There is two theories about his death. The first one is that he shot himself when he felt surrounded by the cops. And the second one is that the cops shot him to death. So this is the end of a mental life of full of rejection, full of hate, full of repulsion. That's why I have to tell you that you should be kind with the next person that you cross path with, because maybe there could be many Campo Elias in the street, and if you don't want to feed a killer's mind, you should be kind. And you should be, because if you're not kind, maybe you can feed a killer's mind that could end in the next fatal crime. That's it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.